You've likely come across the overlay detailing the operational specs of various computer components more than once. For some, it's just about showing the current frame rate during a game, while others might also provide temperature readings for the GPU or CPU. There are times when you might spot a lineup of intricate data that could help savvy users in troubleshooting computer problems. In this video, I'll walk you through how to get the MSI Afterburner software up and running to display this kind of information. Sure, many of our regular viewers may already be well versed in this program and how it works, but we've seen a surge of new subscribers lately, all hungry for knowledge, who may still be building these skills, and confident that this content will help them deepen their grasp of the topic. Who knows, maybe even our long-time followers will find a piece of information here that's new to them. As always, you're bound to come across lots of bonus insights here that you won't find anywhere else. Here with Flowy, and this is the Flow Zone channel. Let's get started. MSI Afterburner and RTSS are valuable tools for PC users. MSI Afterburner is primarily used for overclocking your graphics card, but it also provides a wealth of information about your system's performance. RTSS, on the other hand, is a utility that allows you to cap your FPS to prevent screen tearing, amongst other things. When you download MSI Afterburner, RTSS comes bundled with it. This is great for those who want to display an overlay of data from various PC sensors, giving you real-time performance metrics. However, if your sole purpose is to limit FPS, you can download RTSS separately without needing to install MSI Afterburner. While RTSS does provide the functionality to display sensor readings from your PC, if you're less familiar with these settings or prefer not to spend much time adjusting specific sensor displays, MSI Afterburner might be a more convenient option. It offers an intuitive interface and makes it easier to monitor your system's performance metrics on screen. Just a quick note before we wrap up, I'll be dropping the download links for both RTSS and MSI Afterburner in the description below for your convenience. If you found this content helpful and want to see more from me, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. Your support encourages me to keep producing more videos like this. To begin with, install RTSS using the link provided in the description below and launch the application. At first glance, the interface seems quite straightforward, but the key settings for FPS capping will be discussed in greater detail to clarify their use cases. RTSS is designed to be user-friendly, and even if you're new to it, you should find the interface fairly easy to navigate. Now, let's delve into the options. I'll walk you through them and provide explanations along the way. The Start with Windows option is pretty self-explanatory. You can toggle it on or off depending on your needs. Personally, I only use RTSS when I'm gaming, so I typically enable it just before starting any game I plan to play. The Show On-Screen Display option needs to be active if you want to display sensor readings, something we'll delve into with MSI Afterburner shortly. You also have the option to create unique profiles for different applications. I tend to use just one profile because the games I play are consistently capped at my monitor's refresh rate, meaning the limit remains the same across all games. In RevaTuner Statistics Server, Stealth Mode helps minimize the detection of the overlay by games or applications that might view the overlay as intrusive. It's particularly useful to avoid conflicts with anti-cheat systems that could interpret the on-screen display as a potential cheating tool. However, its effectiveness can vary, and it's crucial to follow the rules of the games you're playing when using tools like RTSS. I recommend using it on medium. The framerate limit feature allows you to cap the maximum frames per second that your game or application can reach, reducing potential issues like screen tearing or CPU and GPU overheating. Because I play competitive, and I never use maximized video settings, I cap my FPS to 240 or 250 depending on game I'm playing. It's important to note that some games like Apex Legends have very good in-game FPS cap, and I would use RTSS with 0 FPS cap and just use it as an on-screen display to watch how my components behave while I'm gaming. On the other hand, for example, Call of Duty has a terrible in-game cap, so I would use RTSS instead. Scanline sync is a feature designed to help eliminate screen tearing without the input lag often associated with VSync. Screen tearing occurs when the graphics card sends frames to the display faster than it can refresh, resulting in two or more frames being shown at once. Traditionally, VSync has been used to prevent this by limiting the GPU's frame output to match the display's refresh rate. However, VSync can cause input lag because it forces the GPU to hold frames until the display is ready. Scanline sync solves this problem by synchronizing the game's frame rate with a specific line on the screen, instead of the entire screen refresh. By setting the synchronization line above the screen, it's possible to hide the tear line outside of the visible display area. Scanline sync is particularly useful when you're experiencing screen tearing, but don't want the input lag that can come with VSync. However, it can be a bit trickier to set up properly, as the optimal settings can vary depending on the specific game and your monitor's resolution. So what's the difference between framerate limit and scanline sync? framerate limit. This feature sets a cap on the maximum frames per second your game or application can achieve. By limiting your framerate, you can prevent your system from rendering unnecessary frames, reducing hardware strain and heat production. However, if the limit is set below the monitor's refresh rate, it can potentially lead to screen tearing, where different frames are displayed at once. Scanline sync. This feature is specifically designed to address screen tearing. Instead of limiting the overall FPS, it synchronizes the game's framerate with a specific line on the screen. This can effectively hide the tear line outside of the visible display area, providing a smoother visual experience. However, setting up scanline sync can be more complex than simply setting a framerate limit, as it requires a fine-tuning process based on your specific game and monitor resolution. In short, framerate limit controls the maximum FPS output by your system to avoid unnecessary workload, while scanline sync tackles screen tearing by synchronizing framerate with a specific line on the screen, providing a smoother image without the potential input lag associated with other solutions like VSync. When to actually use it? Suppose you're playing a fast-paced video game, like a racing game or first-person shooter. You notice that when there's a lot of movement on the screen, the images seem to split, with the top half of the screen showing a slightly different moment than the bottom half. This issue is known as screen tearing, and it can disrupt your gaming experience by making the visuals less smooth and immersive. This is where scanline sync comes in. By enabling this feature in RTSS, you can synchronize the images your computer produces with a specific line on your screen, effectively eliminating the screen tearing and providing a much smoother and more enjoyable gaming experience. Why not to use FPS cap then? While capping the frames per second can help manage system resources and reduce some screen tearing, it doesn't necessarily eliminate the issue entirely. That's because screen tearing primarily happens due to a mismatch between the frame rate of the game and the refresh rate of your monitor. Moreover, a simple FPS cap doesn't address the potential for input lag, which is the delay between your input and the action being carried out on screen. This can be crucial in fast-paced or competitive gaming, where every millisecond counts. On the other hand, scanline sync in RTSS offers a solution that can eliminate screen tearing more effectively without introducing significant input lag, thus providing a smoother gaming experience. However, it might be a bit more complex to set up correctly, as it requires adjusting to your specific monitor and game. It's all about choosing the right tool for the job. If the primary concern is managing system resources and heat, an FPS cap might suffice. But if the goal is to eliminate screen tearing while minimizing input lag, scanline sync could be a more effective choice. When Show On Statistics support feature is enabled, it will display the current frames per second, subject to the cap set by the framerate limit, directly on your application screen. However, if you turn off the OSD support, it will still function in the background, unseen but still limiting the FPS according to your set limit. On-screen display coordinate space setting decides how the program places the OSD on your screen. When set to viewport, the OSD positioning is relative to the active application or game window. This means that if you move or resize the application window, the OSD position will adjust accordingly. On the other hand, when set to frame buffer, the OSD positioning is relative to the entire screen, regardless of the size or position of the active window. This means that the OSD stays in the same place on your screen, even if you move or resize the application window. Settings such as rendering mode, display shadow, fill, palette, and zoom in RTSS or MSI Afterburner essentially control the appearance of the displayed values from these programs. You have the freedom to experiment with these settings to adjust how the displayed information looks according to your preference. Now that we've grasped how RTSS functions, let's take it a step further and integrate some data from MSI Afterburner. We'll be able to monitor aspects like CPU usage, GPU temperature, and more, providing a more comprehensive understanding of our system's performance. For demonstration purposes, I'll be using Apex Legends in windowed mode. This allows me to fit everything onto the screen, enabling us to see in real time what's happening with the system's performance. MSI Afterburner's interface provides a detailed overview of your system's performance metrics, including things like your GPU's temperature, usage, and clock speeds. Next, we'll expand upon this by adding some basic peripheral usage, temperatures, clock speeds, and more to our on-screen display. To do this, you need to click on the Settings button and navigate to the Monitoring tab. From there, in the Active Hardware Monitoring Graphs section, you can choose what you want to monitor on your OSD. To have these metrics display on your screen, simply select the specific graph you want and check the Show in On-Screen Display box. Be sure to have RTSS open during this process. For simplicity, you can mirror the settings from my RTSS interface to ensure all the information is displayed correctly on your screen. Now, let me select a few things I'm particularly interested in. Once Once you've made your selections, don't forget to hit the Apply button to save your settings. You have the flexibility to customize each metric's color, move them around, and more. Now, you're all set to benchmark your PC during gaming sessions. This will help you ensure that everything is functioning as it should, your temperatures are within safe limits, usage is optimal, and your CPU is boosting correctly, among other things. Feel free to experiment with the on-screen display settings within RTSS. Any adjustments you make will have an immediate effect on your display in real time. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more. See you in the next one.